Hello everyone! Welcome to the battlefield, ladies, gentlemen, gentlethems, gentle fluids, and however else you may happen to identify. I am Rustam, the hero of the Persian Empire, reborn in the modern day to battle evil on the internet. Welcome to the new Persian Empire, and congratulations to all of you, but more importantly, thank you for all that you've given me in the past month, because thanks to all of you guys taking the time to be here, to lurk or be in chat or just follow me, thanks to all the support you gave me over the past month, today I finally reached affiliate. I mean, yeah, I haven't exactly fully activated it yet, but yeah. I'm an affiliate now. Or, well, I will be once I get through everything. I honestly don't know what to say. Actually, yeah, I do know what to say. In fact, I said it yesterday. Thank you for everything. And, hold on a sec. She manages showing a blank screen. What the heck's going on there? Oh, there we go. Just had to reload Twitch, I guess, and seems to be working fine now. That was a little bit of a scare. But anyways, yeah, thanks to all of you, the affiliate assault was a success. The affiliate level of Twitch is now in our hands. So much power. Once I manage to fill out all that online paperwork, I'll be able to get ads, get paid, but more importantly, I'll be able to have emotes. Oh, I can hardly wait. I'm salivating just thinking of what kind of emotes I should commission first. It's going to be fun. Oh, yes, and also there's going to be channel points and redeems. I already have a few ideas for what those could be. And I'm very excited to start working on those. And thankfully, since I have the next 2 days off work due to a local event that is taking place, I am going to have plenty of time to work on stuff. That's why my stream for Friday is scheduled a bit earlier than usual. I have time. There's nothing as nice as getting some days off, is there? Just imagining all that free time. I'm probably gonna waste a lot of it doing nothing instead of enjoying the nice weather. But, it's my time to waste, I guess. Then again, I really don't have any time to waste, do I? I've got a lot of work to do. I gotta do everything I can to make the stream better than it already is. After all of you guys gave me your support. And it's now my turn to return that by giving you guys the best show I can. And of course, by doing my best to make everything I've dreamed of doing with the stream actually happen. And I'll go into detail on that later. Speaking of later, that's also when I will be doing an actual celebration of our reaching affiliate status, because this is just a scheduled stream. I feel like I gotta do something special for this. Reaching affiliate. Gotta say, May 1st will be an easy affiliate anniversary to remember. I mean, I guess Twitch won't register it as the anniversary, but in my mind, it's the anniversary. Anyways. I suppose we should Get started with the game. It has been a while since we played Lego Star Wars. Should be fun. I can't wait to watch this, not just season finale, but the show finale, the final episode of The Bad Batch after stream. It's a pity that I didn't watch it, like, with anyone, because I would have loved to, like, have a watch party for something as special as this. The Bad Batch has definitely become one of my favorite Star Wars media of all time. And, honestly, if people are interested, I don't see any reason why I shouldn't or couldn't start doing a little watch party binge session of the entire show on Discord. Having movie nights and show nights on Discord would certainly be fun. If the Discord ever fills up more, then I definitely want to do stuff like that. Community streams and watch parties and whatnot. It'll be fun. I do hope that you guys will join me for those. If that stuff you're interested in. I know we keep rather late hours around here, so that might be a bit of an issue. But I guess we'll just have to see, won't we? When the best time is and if we can make that happen. I certainly hope we can. And right then, I think that's enough talk. Let's just switch over. And now, it's time to get started. I wonder just how much grief Twitch is going to give me over all the copyrighted music this time. Every time I have a VOD, it's muted to heck and back. At least when I'm playing this game. Just a random Wookiee. Just a random old man. I think I'm gonna go with this little pairing. We got the old man and his favorite Jedi to groom. We have quite a lot of credits saved up, so let's see what we can grab before we head in. As I recall, the last time we played this game, we finished off episode 4. So now we can start one of the best Star Wars movies of all time in Lego form. This is going to be a lot of fun. Let's see. A Jawa, the spy, Beach Trooper, Death Star Trooper, TIE Fighter Pilot, Imperial Officer, Tarkin. Quite a lot of Imperials to unlock. You know what? Maybe I will wait on buying new things. What's this? Locked. Poo money. I think I'm good on that one. I don't think I need that. Super Jedi Slam. Deflect bolts. Should be useful.
Oh, hey, it's General Grievous. You know what? Let's get rid of the Jedi Guardian and just have Grievous kidnap the Chancellor again. Come on, old man. Where do you think you're going? Come on. We're going somewhere else. It's neat how Grievous puts his upper arms together to have, like, the two blades like that when he jumps the first time and the second time, too. I just love the animations on Grievous. I really do. It is cold in here. Then again, I don't think Grievous feels the cold anymore. Okay, old man, there's a force thing here, so do your thing. Man, suds always disappear far too quickly. Nice. We murdered a snowman. Let's see, what's this? Episode 3, Swamp Clone. Man, they really had no respect for clones back in the day. It's just like, oh, this is a clone from episode 3 from the swamp. No mention of which unit he's with, no mention of who is his commanding officer, none of that. It's just, this is a clone from episode 3 from the swamp. No, nothing like 313th Attack Battalion or any, something like that, you know? These days, even Fortnite pays more respect to the clones and has more accurate information on the skins than this game does. It's honestly a sad thing to see. I mean, like, Fortnite, of all things, did better by the clones than this game. It's messed up. Then again, this came out pretty much when episode 3 had wrapped. Up! I made an oopsie! Come on, let's go. Going from one battle to another, I guess.
Episode 5, The Empire Strikes Back, Chapter 1, Hoth Battle. It is a dark time for the Rebellion. Although the Death Star has been destroyed, Imperial troops have driven the Rebel forces from their hidden base and pursued them across the galaxy. Evading the dreaded Imperial Starfleet, a group of freedom fighters led by Luke Skywalker has established a new secret base on the remote ice world of Hoth. The evil Lord Darth Vader, obsessed with finding young Skywalker, has dispatched thousands of remote probes into the far reaches of space.
Oh, neat. It's a little mini Star Destroyer with flickering lighting. Oof. We're just speedrunning through the opening plot of episode 5. Come on, Luke, you can do it. I love how shocked he is. He's like, dude, what the heck? Hey, Han. Uh-oh. It's just a regular Star Destroyer. No Super Star Destroyer. I love the mustache on that guy. Rip mustache guy. I call dibs on that mustache, by the way, if he's not gonna be using it anymore. Whoa. Wait, what? You can tie up the ATSTs? What? Yo, that's crazy. Aw, man. Well, at least I didn't get any money yet, so it's all good. I am definitely gonna get copyrighted for the Battle of Hoth music, but I do not care. I love this music so much. This is the music I used to hear when playing Shadows of the Empire. It's so nostalgic. These guys just let me keep farming them. It's really sweet of them. Money! God, I love this music. Come to think of it, I have Shadows of the Empire. Maybe I should stream that at some point during Star Wars month. God, that would be so nostalgic. What do you guys think? Is Shadows of the Empire something you'd be interested in? I'm friendly firing my own guys and I feel nothing. Look at all the little rebels over there. I wonder, can I friendly fire those guys? It's a messed up thing to wonder, but I so think about it. I'm gonna see. I mean, they're Lego, so they'll be fine. I can just rebuild them. Huh? I thought there was something near that cave or in that cave. No, my money! I won't be forced back into a life of poverty! Yay! My money! It's back. It's past your bedtime. Fall down. Fall down. Fall down. Okay, fine. I'll leave you alone. There's nothing like just flying around crazily dodging blaster bolts. It's the go-to strategy for this game. Is that a speeder bike? Ha, you gotta admire his nerve. He really thought a speeder bike was gonna take me down. No! No! Stealing my blue coins. Unforgivable. Truly unforgivable. Well, looks like I made back my money. Now I just gotta keep it. Hmm. Says to go here, but I'm gonna have to get the bombs and blow it up, aren't I? Yeah, I'm gonna have to go get the... Okay, I'm starting to see what this level's all about. I gotta dodge through enemy fire and everything else, all while carting a bomb. This could be annoying. Da da do 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 do. Yes, this is going to be very annoying. Very annoying indeed. I'm so slow carting this thing out. No! No! Blast it all. At least it hasn't blown up. I still got a chance. There we go. Alright, we made it through. Now let's see what... This is my favorite part of Star Wars games. Nothing. This is what makes the Battle of Hoth the most classic gaming moment in Star Wars, at least to me. There is nothing that can ever beat wrapping up an AT-ST. Nothing. Hit him at the bomb, hit him at the bomb, hit him at the bomb, and... Where's the bomb? There's the bomb. Ha ha, got him! God, I love Hoth. I love it so much. Star Wars at its best, at its most classic. You cannot go wrong with Hoth. You just can't. Come on, guys, why don't you split up a little? It would sure make chasing little old me around a lot easier, wouldn't it? Oh, I see. You just pulled them over. Huh. So I don't need to fly around at all. I literally can just pull and they go down. That's neat. I need another heart, and you look like you have one. Give it to me. You useless piece of scrap metal. You had one job. Give me a heart. And you failed it miserably. If I die, I will drag you to hell with me. He's half buried in the snowdrift already. Da-da-dum. You really think you can hit me? I am a master ATST Wrangler. I've been doing this since I was a kid. Huh? What's this now? Oh, hey, Cruising. How you doing? Good to see ya. You're just in time to watch us murder another ATST. Alright, come on, my little round friend. The honor is yours. You love to see it, you really do. It's like I said, there's nothing more quintessentially, classically Star Wars than wrapping up a giant robot camel and dragging him to his death. There really isn't. Tell me there's something better. You can't. We'll just do this the old-fashioned way. For those two, anyway. I don't believe the game has... What? Hold on a sec. I forgot to unmute the desktop audio. That is the second time in as many weeks that I have forgotten to unmute the desktop audio, and at least this time someone told me about it. Last time I went the entire stream with Tears of the Kingdom completely muted. I even unlocked a cutscene, and I didn't realize until later that like no one could hear that cutscene. Thank you, Cruising. I really appreciate that. I would have been really messed up if that happened twice. I need to get better. I need to just unmute the desktop audio at the start of stream, I think. That way I don't forget. Alright. There we go. Kaboom! Okay, looks like we need to crack a few more. They may take our lives, but they'll never take our money! I am just knocking the crap out of these guys. Let's see, is there anything in here? Anything interesting? I feel like I unlocked a mini kit. It should be around here somewhere. Shouldn't it? I don't know, they can take our Legos. What do you think they're using to build all their vehicles? It's all Lego. It's not a question of whether or not they can take our Legos. It's a question of whether or not they can take our money. Because Luke needs money to become a true Jedi. It's a little known secret that the Jedi were pretty elitist. You had to be rich to get in. Okay, that might be Imperial propaganda. I don't know. It's been a long time since there were any real Jedi. No one really knows this stuff anymore. Nice try, boys. Lesson learned, don't play chicken with the scout walker. Okay, I think that's the second time I friendly fired turrets on my own side. Oh, they seem to be doing just fine, though. What did we make those turrets out of? Whatever it is, I want to put my snowspeeder in it. Yep. This is classic Lego Star Wars right here. Nothing but farming for studs. Hi, sir, does anyone know what those probe droids are saying? I always thought they were saying something like heir to the system, which is like, what on earth is the heir to the system? What are you saying? Probe droids are weird. I absolutely adore the fact that you can do that in this game. You can just yank and topple over the AT-STs. That's not something you could do in any other game. Last I checked. Ow! More rocks to shoot. Yay, more money. Now there's one last thing I need to check. There it is. What's this thing here? Hooray! Brum bum bum. Hmm. The wall's gone, yep. What's this? A probe droid parade? Oh, I see. We need to kill them. And we can take our time. I'm more interested in blowing up these rocks. No! All right, that's a little more money in the coffers. It's nice to have a power up. Now I can hunt for money without any interference. Okay, there's like one probe droid left, so I really need to avoid killing him for now anyways. Okay, here. This should give me enough money, hopefully. It did not give me enough money. But it did give me a heart to evade the onslaught. Okay. Just a little more. Are there any more rocks anywhere? I think those dishes give off money. Yes, they do. No! No, 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 no! Oh, no. One last one, one last one. Got it. Alright. Anymore, anymore, anymore. Where? Where's the money? Well, the rocks are all gone, so... blasted. I think we're out of... Wait, nope. Here come the chicken walkers. Okay. Aw, man, it's still not enough. And so this game really brings out the Wario in me. Oh, I just remembered something. I can't believe I forgot. Ba-ba-ba, where is it? No, it's not here. There we go. No. Alright, we did it! We are finally a true Jedi. For this level, anyways. And all it took was turning on character studs. Alright, well, now I can focus on killing these guys with impunity and extreme prejudice. Huh. That AT-AT is just marching on down slowly. Just taking his own sweet time. This is amazing. I'm getting showered in money. It's like a bunch of piñatas. A swarm of piñatas descending upon me. Now, where is that last chicken? Ah, there he is. Since you're the last one, I will grant you a pleasant nap. He died in his sleep. A merciful death. Alright, big guy. Let's do this. Let's wrap this up quick, shall we? See what I did there. Alright, now where are those bombs? There's one. Nope. Man. Come back. Not you. Damn. The big guys are back up on their feet. Oh man, I really had it good for a while, but now I'm getting blown up a lot. The enemies had time to regroup, and I'm not doing too well with carting those bombs over to the AT-ATs. Man, this is why I don't play Overwatch. I hate payloads. God, they're all over the place. Alright, let's take care of this guy first. We can wrap up the other one later. Dang it! There we go. That did it. For the other one. Alright. Here we go again. Let's try and do it right this time. No! No! Really, guys, what did I ever do to you? I mean, other than brutally slaughter you and your comrades and take your money. Look, this is war. Those were my spoils. They are not yours. I know they were originally yours, but they are yours no longer. So kindly, stop trying to take what I have rightfully earned. Come on, come on, come on, come on. Yeah! What? You gotta be kidding me. What? How do I keep missing this guy? What is this? I thought I had the force, but this is some sorcery. Speaking of sorcery, is anyone else watching that new sorcerer anime? What was it? No, I'm not talking about Jujutsu Kaisen. I'm talking about this one that's come out this season. The one with the elf. The Archdemon's Dilemma. That one. I'll be honest, like, when I first heard about it, I was really skeptical. Like, okay, so they're starting off with the traditional dude buys a slave gimmick. Yeah, I'm really not a big fan of this, of the direction. But I feel like, I don't know, watching it, I'm not trying to defend it too much, but like, I've been enjoying that show, like just the growing relationship between the characters. I think it is sweet. And what I do like about it is that, like, unlike a lot of other anime that really do the issue of slavery very poorly, the sorcerer dude, like from day one, he's like, I don't care if this girl runs away from me later, I'm gonna find a way to set her free. And like, a main focus for like most of the episodes that have been released thus far is like just letting her go, getting her free. He does intend to do right by her and, you know, not abuse the fact that she's a slave. Which is, you know, a nice change of pace, I think. Because, like, a lot of anime do tend to, like, romanticize slavery as, like, you know, oh, they're not really slaves. They want to be slaves. They like being slaves. And it's like, no one likes that. I don't know where you got that, but no one likes that. And so it's nice that this one is, like, you know, okay, we're not going to pretend that this person, that it's okay just because this person likes the guy. He's getting that collar off. So yeah, I am enjoying that one anime. Oh man. Run, Luke, run! Poor Dak. They couldn't even get his body to have a funeral. Nice work, Luke. You did good. Unlike my laptop, which seems to be determined to disconnect every opportunity it gets. And every time it disconnects, I can no longer see OBS. I have said it before, and I am probably going to say it a lot in the future until I actually get a second monitor. But I really need a second monitor. I need to hurry up and figure out what my current monitor is, because, like, I want the same one. Honestly, even if it's not the same one at this point, any monitor would suffice.
Episode 5, The Empire Strikes Back. Chapter 2, Escape from Echo Base. Imperial forces have mounted a relentless assault on the Rebel base on Hoth. The Rebel fighters have held out bravely, but the enemy is overwhelming. In the Echo Base Command Center, carved deep into the ice of the frozen planet, Han Solo and Princess Leia monitor the evacuation of Rebel personnel, but as stormtroopers reach the outer defenses, they must quickly find an escape route for themselves.
Aw, man. Alright. Well, before we start the next level, I'm gonna try and reconnect my laptop, because I really prefer to see OBS when I am streaming. There we go. Connect it again, and this time hopefully it stays that way. Okay, there we go. Okay, that should do it. Hopefully it stays connected this time. And back to the game. Gotta say, Han looks really snazzy with his blue jacket. Man's got style. I feel like we should, like, destroy these to prevent the Empire from getting information. But it seems we aren't allowed to do that. Pity we don't have a droid. Well, we killed the princess while trying to save her. Luke is never gonna let me hear the end of this. Heh. Nothing beats a good old punch to the noggin. What is this, a space heater? I mean, we could certainly use one. It's freezing out here. But this is a good opportunity to practice my marksmanship. Yep, that's one heck of a quick draw. Good on ya, Han, old boy. Huh, that was a space heater. Those boys were just heating themselves by the fire and we murked them. Well, that's what they get for trying to relax while being on duty. Seriously, guys, what were you thinking? If I hadn't scrapped them, Vader probably would have. I mean, I get that it's cold here. We've been here for like months on end. But it's still not a good idea to slack off while on the job. Come on, Leia, let's get some coffee or whatever. Yummy. Nice, warm coffee. Well, that didn't work. Let's try that again. Nope, they got me. But in return, I got them. And I stole their wallets. money. Let's see. Wait up. There we go. What's this do? Don't do nothing, huh? Wait a sec. Wait, no. Well, that's just great. Now how am I supposed to get all that money up there? Man. Alright, let's see what we got here. We need four people. I think I understand what this stuff is for. These guys are so rude. I build a gun and they blow it up. Oh man, poor 3PO lost so. You guys just don't learn, do ya? Go on, buddy. I know you only got one arm, but do your best. Attaboy, 3PO, good work. Oh, that's bad. Ow. Well, at least you got plenty of cover here. Stick behind cover, Han. Man. Jerks. Well, let's try and recoup what we can before we fly the coop. Oh, now I remember. First of us used that to get 3PO over this thing, since he can't jump like a chump. There we go. Whoops. Aw, man. There we go. Finally got him over. These guys always show up. Go away. I'm trying to collect the money from your remains. Oh, Well, looks like they're gone. Let's go! Better avoid the grates. It all fell down. It all fell in the hole! I remember this part. Not tall enough for that one. I think I'll risk the pit to grab some more blue coins. There we go. And then there's one more. Okay, maybe let's not risk it. Oh, sorry, bud. That's Chewy. Oh, man. He sounds like he's in some serious trouble. Whoa! No! How was I supposed to know that was a pit? That's messed up. Why is it a pit? That's so messed up. Hop, 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 staying alive, staying alive. Hop, 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 staying on ice, staying on ice. Looks like we can't get in there. Where? Up, there he is. Come on, Chewie, this way. Or not. Okay. man. Get away from my ship. So many goodies in this one hangar. I doubt we'll be able to collect them all, but it would be nice to be able to. I don't think that's how ray shields work, and I'm pretty sure those are ray shields. What exactly do we need tauntauns for anyway? Okay, now we have tauntauns. What are you guys gonna do? Oh, that's what you guys are gonna do. Did it just jump? I saw the tauntaun jump. That's crazy. Okay, let's see. How is jumping supposed to... Okay, yeah. I don't think that's gonna work. So much money. Okay, now I see what the tauntauns were for. Now let's see. How do we get to the red brick? Okay, we may not be able to do that right now. Let's go. Aw, man. Whoa! Ouch! There they go. One tiny minikit piece. Wait, what? Now we get to earn money from the gold bricks we collect? That's awesome. Okay, we are an hour in and I have not eaten since I got back from work, so I'm gonna take a quick break, grab a little snack, grab a little drink of water, and come back fresh. Okay, see you guys in a sec.
Alright, we're back, everyone. Good to see y'all. That was a good snack. I haven't had one of those little dark chocolates with mint filling pieces in a while. That was a good little treat. Dark chocolate is always wonderful, but pair it with mint and that's good stuff. Really good stuff. Really freshens you up. Anyways, let's get back to it, shall we? Let me just unmute the desktop audio this time.
Episode 5, The Empire Strikes Back. Chapter 3, Falcon Flight. Led by the evil Darth Vader, Imperial forces have overrun the rebel base on the ice planet Hoth. Having bravely stalled the enemy advance, Luke Skywalker has made his escape by X-Wing fighter. And as the last rebel transports lift off from the planet, Han Solo and the Millennium Falcon engages the Imperial ships above.
Oh boy. Out of the frying pan and into the fire. It's nice that the turbo lasers on the Falcon can change direction. That's pretty useful. Then again, the Falcon is a pretty big target. I swear to God, any game you play the Falcon in, it's always just an oversized target. Every time. You would think that, you know, they would at least reflect that the Falcon has, like, better shielding than most ships to make up for its bulk. But no, they never show that. Sucks. Give me an X-Wing or a Y-Wing, please. Instead of this frickin' minivan. Alright, bit by bit, we're evacuating the rebel fleet. Fleet's out of there. That's our turn now. Or not. Whoa! Out of the fire, and into the oven. Neat, you can blow up the asteroids to get torpedoes. That's fun. Ow. Yep. When you think of the Millennium Falcon, this is the piece I usually hear. God, John Williams is so good. I'm telling you, modern cinema as it exists would not be the way it is without John Williams. Frankly, neither would any of the franchises with whose music he did. Star Wars, Jaws, and so many others. Most people can only aspire to have a legacy as storied as his. Decades from now, people will still be listening to his music, even long after he's dead and gone. That's honestly amazing. But then again, I guess that is the dream for any musical artist, isn't it? To have your music leave an impact like that. I can only hope to make a similar impact one day, I guess. Well, there we go, True Jedi. Now then, one last little rock to blow up. Kaboom! We're through. Give me back my torpedoes, you jerks. That minivan will do the Kessel Run in less than 12 parsecs. Maybe, but that's only in light speed. In real space, it's a tank. Seriously, the Falcon's supposed to have good shields, but this thing just soaks up blaster fire like a sponge. Mm. Alright, here we go. Ow. Get out of here. This is my hoop. Mine. Ow. Go find your own little space canyon to fly around in. This one's mine. Shoot. Get out of here. Han really needs to stock the Millennium Falcon with more proton torpedoes. This is just ridiculous, having to hunt for ammunition in asteroids. But seriously, why did the asteroids have so much ammunition? These asteroids are strapped. Why? Oh, great. Am I gonna have to go all the way back there just to grab more asteroids? Bleh. Just to grab more torpedoes? Looks like it. No! We got three of these things. You know what? I'm a little curious as to what this does, so let's make some Ooh! Nice. Die. Imperial Sleemo. Ow! Let's see, are there any more of those torpedo holes left? No. I see. Very well then. Let's go get some more torpedoes. Okay, let's blow this up first. Off we go. You know, it always amazes me that Han is able to fly the Falcon so well, given that, like, the cockpit is literally on the side of the thing, so like, he has to account for the fact that the bulk of the ship is to his left. That's honestly pretty impressive, right, when you think about it. Because like, any other plane, like, in a plane or something, like, you're pretty centrally located. At least the cockpit is centrally located. So you can see directly ahead of you. And you have a pretty good idea of, like, where the craft is at all times. Han does not have that. He has a little tiny cockpit on the side, and the majority of the ship just dangling off the side of it. The fact that he's able to fly this thing so well like that is honestly either a testament to the technology or a testament to the pilot. Though it might be a bit of both. It's kind of funny that there are so many TIE Interceptors, considering that in the movies we never saw any TIE Interceptors until Return of the Jedi. But here they're all over the place. Here we go again. More asteroids. Whoa, boy, that's a big honking asteroid. Not again. Go away! Let me alone! You already took my money. What do you want? You know you can't kill me permanently. Not again. Okay, just one more hit and this thing's done. Wait. Go back to Vader, tell him you had a sword, tell me it's something, I don't care, just leave me alone. Finally, let's get out of here. Oh my god, I can't believe they ejected the Gonk droid into space. How could they do such a thing to Lord Gonk? It's unfathomable. I don't believe it. I can't believe it. It's disgusting. Oh my goodness, look at all the money we're stacking up. Well, we are at the 2 hour mark, so what do you guys want to do? You guys want to keep going a little longer? Maybe finish the entirety of episode 5 today? Or you guys want to call it a night? To be honest, I think I can keep going. I don't have any work tomorrow. I can keep going for as long as I want to. But then again, I do want to stream a bit earlier tomorrow. So in that sense, I guess I still kind of have obligations at my usual work time. Wait, no, what am I saying? Tomorrow's a break day. I'm getting my schedule all mixed up. Yeah, I know. Tomorrow's the break day. I can keep going. I think I'm gonna keep going. But before we get back to episode 5, I say we do a little bit of shopping. Oh man, how'd I end up stuck with Goldenrod again? I don't understand how Greedo is worth 60,000. I really don't. Heh! Han with the hood! Rebel Trooper, a pilot, Snow Trooper, Luke on Hoth. Look at him with his little woolly hat. It's so cute. Bomber, Imperial Shuttle. And with that, we have officially unlocked pretty much every single ship. I wonder if there's an A-Wing we can unlock later. I hope so. I would love to unlock the A-Wing and B-Wing later. But then again, this isn't a Rogue Squadron game, unfortunately. Wow. We have unlocked pretty much everything that we currently have access to. And character-wise, that is. That is pretty impressive. It's amazing what saving up a little can do for you. Oh, this is gonna be so useful. Let's see, can we afford any more gold bricks? $50,000, no less. Alright. Well, that's a whole lot of unlock. I'm so glad I decided to go shopping. Look how crowded the cantina is now. There's so many people. Oh neat, Ki-Adi Mundi. This is a fun little duo. We got Ki-Adi Mundi and we got Indiana Jones. This is a fun little combo. Look at him go. Alright then. Dagobah. Off to the swamp.
Episode 5. The Empire Strikes Back. Chapter 4. Dagobah. Han Solo and Princess Leia have finally evaded the Imperial fleet in the Millennium Falcon. And are on their way to Cloud City, secretly followed by the bounty hunter, Boba Fett. Meanwhile, following instructions relayed to him by the spectral form of Obi-Wan Kenobi, Luke Skywalker has piloted his X-Wing to the forgotten planet of Dagobah. Accompanied by his trusty droid R2-D2, Luke heads towards the murky swamp world in search of his destiny.
R2 doesn't seem too happy about this. Nice flying, Luke! Really nice flying. R2, you alright? Yeah, he's fine.
Uh-oh. R2! Whoa! You alright, buddy? Yikes. Well, this is a rather interesting place. I really don't understand why Luke's blaster makes that noise. I wonder. I was thinking if I waited out, maybe, Sorry, R2. Sorry. Anyways, I was thinking that if we waited out, then maybe, that monster would come out. And I thought that would be funny. If Luke just got eaten by the sea monster. But nope. Sadly, there was no sea monster out there. Man, all this eerie music, and it's just like a bat. Honestly, Star Wars does have like vampire-like people, but I don't think any of them are on Dagobah. We don't gotta worry about the Anzari on Dagobah. Huh? Wow, that is a very big snake. Heh, punch the bat. Luke, make sure to wear a breath mask. You don't know where those bats have been, and the last thing we need is COVID-24. Yikes! I swear I don't taste good, leave me alone. R2, do something! R2! I hate snakes. Yikes! Man. Legos really just can't swim worth a dang. Can't swim worth a dime. But R2 can- wait. R2 can swim? So like, Luke falls in and he just frickin' dies, but R2 falls in and he can swim? That is so not fair. Oh neat, there's money down here. Oh, that's neat. Now, how do I get over there? R2, do you think you can maybe get over there? Possibly? He can. Wonderful. Yoda's gonna be ticked off at me, I think, for wrecking his lawn. Or his garden, or whatever this place is to him. I'm sure it must mean something to him. What on earth is a droid terminal doing here? Yoda must have sensed we were coming ahead of time and rolled out the welcome mat. Oh, sorry, R2. I'm just shooting the bushes. Okay, I guess we are being urged forward in this direction. Neat. A button. I think you have a better chance of reaching that than I do. Man, a Jedi could navigate this place pretty easily. It sure would be nice if we had a Jedi. Ha, Luke. Wouldn't that be nice? If there was a Jedi around here to, you know, use the Force and just jump all over the place. That would be nice, don't you think? No! Made it. So many 4C looking rocks. Oh, hey Yoda. Check it out, I got a lightsaber. So, will you train me? Nah, probably not. Whoa! See, Luke, he is a Jedi. Something which you are clearly not. Alright, guess we got a little time skip. Looks like Luke is starting to learn the ways of the Jedi. Look at him running around with his lightsaber in the Ataru position. Look at him go. Flipping all over the place. Oh, that reminds me. Okay, character says on. Force pull. Might as well turn that on. Super Jedi Slam, deflect boots. Yeah, let's just turn all the extras on. Da 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 da. I cannot climb this tree. Man. He was just watching. He's watching the bats eat me. So like, am I supposed to use the force to blow up the plants, or like, what? I feel like that's not really a Jedi. Okay, I guess Luke is not yet strong enough to use the force on these plants. These bats just keep respawning, and I in turn keep getting money from them. It's a nice little system of symbiosis. Are the bats coming because I keep attacking the plants? Is that why they keep flying out of the woodwork to try and hurt me? Oh, I get it. We need Yoda. Wait, what? Ow! Neat, so Yoda's an actual vehicle. That's kind of weird. Like, instead of us riding the vehicle's riding us. That's kind of crazy. Bats do not care about R2 in the slightest. Yeah, I'm just gonna leave Luke to get beaten up by bats while I go for a swim in this disgusting water. You may be wondering why I feel the need to do this. And there is a rather simple answer. I'm looking for Shrek. Are you guys done harassing the child? Man, not again. Guys, come on. He's just a baby. Stop messing with the baby Jedi. Man, just by coming over here, I can get Luke to do all the puzzle work on his own. There you are. Yep, Luke can do nothing on his own. Man. Hey! See if I ever help you again. Well, R2, you're gonna go up there, or... Come on, man. That's it. Made it. Now rise, my mushroom friend. Rise and bring me closer to my goal. Yes. Seriously though, who put this gate here? Yoda, just what have you been doing while you've been stranded on Dagobah? You've been engaging in some very interesting engineering projects. Nice work, Luke. Now you can use the Force on your own. Good work, my boy. Once a farm boy, always a farm boy. Oh wow, we're back to where we started. We can't go into Yoda's house. I'm gonna blow up all the plants like no one ever did. Cause I'm a Jedi now and I can. Da 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 something dumb. Can I ride the bike? Can I ride the bike? I cannot ride the bike. Honestly, I guess I don't really have much of a reason to ride a bike. My dad isn't around to teach me. Hey Yoda, can you tell me anything about my dad? What was he like? Wait, what? Wait, what? Oh my god, we're back here. Oh my god, we're back here. those bats have to be so frustrated like by now. They're like, oh my god, he's back. Why is he back? What did we ever do, man? Leave us alone. The poor bats. They really don't deserve this. Man. Just hopping around. R2 should be able to swim across and join us. Yep, there he is. Hey, buddy. Let's go. Okay, little buddy. You're gonna have to, yep, just cross over. Where'd Yoda get himself to? Man, for some reason I can't access my blaster anymore. Something about Jedi don't carry blasters. I guess that means I cannot go over there. What a pity. I gotta go in the cave? Aw, fine. I wonder what these mushrooms are. I wonder if I can eat them. Bye, R2. Come on, you gotta let me up there, man. There's money up there. Come on, let me up, let me up. Be your best friend. I'm so close. Let me up. I want the money. Fine. There's so many different kinds of mushrooms in here. Ah! Hey Yoda, you ever tried any of these? You know, just tweak a little. Is that what they say, tweak? I don't know. I get the feeling that's the way we're supposed to go. Ah! No! Man. Okay, I get it. I'm not allowed over there. Jeez. Just dropping money into the pit pointlessly. Alright, now how do we get R2 up there? I'm starting to get the feeling we cannot get R2 up there, and that he simply has to find another way to do things. Ah, yes, the classic Yoda death noise. No! What the heck? What is Darth Vader doing here? He just poofed out of existence. And so did all the money. How do we get up there? There he goes, back to the ground floor. He disappeared. What was up with that? Boom. There we go, drawbridge raised. Ow. No! No! You stinking bat. So close, yet so far. Gardening really is therapeutic and lucrative. Neat. True Jedi. Let's go. Ha ha! Over here. Oh, neat, it's a washing machine. Oh, I should have asked Yoda if he wanted to do some laundry. I get the feeling his roads are pretty dirty. I mean, he's been here for like how long? And he's never like done laundry once. Then again, he might have done laundry the old-fashioned way. This. Oh, my ship. Looks like I can't get it out all the way. You're up, Yoda. Show the youngin' how it's done. Whoa, 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 you're leaving just like that? Already? Really, Luke? See, even they agree you really shouldn't be leaving so soon. At least stay for dinner. You're disappointing Ben's ghost. Look at him. Okay, fine. Leave. See if I care. Almost at the 3-hour mark. Let's do one more level, complete episode 5, and then I think we can call it a night. Maybe I'll do some free play tomorrow on my own time. Or maybe I can stream it in the Discord. Maybe I should just start streaming on Discord whenever I want to do a little solo gaming. Anyways, episode 5, The Empire Strikes Back, chapter 5, Cloud City Trap. Barely a few weeks into his Jedi training with Yoda, Luke Skywalker has had a vision of his friends captured by Darth Vader. Against Yoda's advice, the impetuous young Jedi sets his X-Wing fighter on a course for Cloud City. Here, he hopes to find Han Solo and Princess Leia, little guessing in his haste that he himself is the true target of Vader's trap. Okay, so that's kind of odd that the text scroll gives us a definitive timeline for Luke's training. Like, we're never given an explicit nod to how long it's been, how long he's been there. It could have been months or even a year or two, but we don't know exactly how long Luke was on Dagobah. I know Luke's a quick study and all, but I feel like he would have at least been there for, I don't know, a few months at least? Like, cause seriously, Luke's training was really rushed. Also, where did he get a change of clothes? Look at him. He's all spiffed out in this, Bespin suit. It's got pockets and everything. Whoa! Is this any way to greet a stranger? You guys are seriously lacking in the hospitality department. I'm not gonna be giving this place any nice reviews on Yelp. Okay, that's it. Think you can make it over there from here? He cannot. Oh, neat, he made it over. Pity he can't do anything about this. Nice. Whoa! Shock, 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 shock. Seriously, so inhospitable. These guys are awful. Alright, R2, you're up. See what you can do with this. Heh, I just hit him out of the air. Every single trooper you send to me, Vader, you only increase the size of my wallet. And your own body count. Well, not body count, but casualty rate, I guess, would be the more accurate descriptor. This is getting old, guys. It's a good thing I had character studs. I don't think I would have been able to hit two Jedi so quickly otherwise. Maybe not even at all. Where's a bounty hunter when you need one? R2, you're up. Might as well grab it as guys, that'll make this infiltration a lot easier. Hello, Lord Vader. Wait, I'm just a random stormtrooper, I swear! Don't hit me! Have I done something to displeasure you, my lord? I'm sorry. Whatever it is, I promise I'll take care of it right away. Stop swinging your lightsaber, please! Okay, fine. If that's how you're gonna be, take this! I have deceived you. I'm not a random stormtrooper at all. I'm Luke Skywalker, hero of the rebellion. Why are you playing tag, man? Ouch, that's gotta hurt. Sorry, R2. Also sorry, R2. I'm gonna see if R2 can shock him. Got him. Wait, he can activate stormtrooper panels? Seriously? Alright, R2. You're going for a little ride. There you go. Thanks, R2. So that's why I need to get a stormtrooper helmet. No! Oh, I just had a thought. I can't believe I didn't think of this before, back on Dagobah. That would have saved me a fair bit of time. Going to the dark side. Looks like opening the middle really just doesn't do anything at all. That's kind of a pity. I was hoping for something interesting to happen with that. But I guess not. Still, I should definitely have had the dark side on Dagobah. There were so many little dark side things I could have hit with that. Oh, neat, I've even got the red lightsaber. Gotta admit, it looks pretty good. With the Stormtrooper helmet and the Bespin outfit, yeah, it looks pretty good on Luke. But it's kinda thematically inappropriate, so... Yep, we're going back to the light side. Dang it. Where's R2 when I need him? Oh man, it won't allow us to use that trick to get the mini kit. Curse those developers, they thought of it. No, no! Aw, man. Now that I have learned the secret of automatic blaster deflection, calling in your support team won't work anymore, Vader. There's nothing you can do to stop me. Nothing! Ha ha ha! Stop shooting my droid! Here we go again. Honestly, I think I'm losing a little bit of energy here. Or maybe a bit more than just a little bit. Either way, I am glad that this is the last level we'll be doing. Because I am feeling kind of worn out. Good lord, that's not good actually. Because I still need to work out after this. I haven't worked out once all week. Get back down here. Running away again. You really are a coward. I wonder how such a cowardly dude could kill my father. It seems impossible. But Ben told me it happened, so... he must be right. No one cares about R2 just jetting around doing his own thing. Even Vid is like, I'm just gonna stay here and watch the stormtrooper shoot Luke. Even though I need him alive. I guess that's not the way to get to that. How do I get to that? Threw him out the window. Now, seriously, how do I get that? I'll figure it out later. R2, be a lineman, get that one, will ya?
No.
Ouch. Here we go. Oh man, that hurt. What's you got there? Wait, is that a family photograph? It can't be. So long, Vader. I don't care if you are my father. You look terrible in that photograph. Ah. Wait, there's more?
Episode 5, The Empire Strikes Back. Chapter 6, Betrayal Over Bespin. Escaping from the rebel defeat on Hoth, Han Solo has sought sanctuary on Cloud City, high above the planet Bespin. His old friend Lando Calrissian is now Baron Administrator of the self-governing colony. And Han hopes for a warm welcome. But in this time of galactic upheaval, nothing is as it seems.
Looks like we've still got another level to go. Oh wow, snubbed. Dang it. Wink. Oh no. You're not getting away that easy. Booba! Some Mandalorian you are, running like a coward. Okay, I'm starting to see. Boba, you are thoroughly disgracing your Mandalorian heritage right now. That's where I can stand and fight! I'm gonna slap the helmet off you, just like what happened to your father. Ha! You didn't think this fop could fight, did you? Well, joke's on you, Boba. I've learned plenty of moves in my day. Coward! Oh man, that poor civilian. Wow, with the Flex Blaster Bolts on, unless there's a Jedi around, I'm pretty much invincible. This is kind of sucking all the fun out of it. He can't hurt me. None of them can. Looks like Lando can pull off the old quick draw trick just like Khan can. I get the feeling that given, I think since we're on this level, it's only appropriate that we turn this on. It's the only level where it actually works. Like, where it actually makes sense. Don't you run, Boba! He's running! Aw, man, that poor Cloud City guy. Whoa, R2, where'd you come from? Oh. Aw, man. I can never overstate how much I love the comedy in this game. Thank you. Heh, just a little kick to his leg. Ow! Nothing personal, boys, but I lost a lot of money because of the poison gas, so now I gotta make it back. Off of your corpses, I'm afraid. I'm so sorry, but it's just what has to be done. It really is. No hard feelings. I didn't realize, but this is kind of just, the music here is kind of a, the music just then was like a sped up version of the music on Dagobah when Yoda is lifting Luke's X-Wing. Those Ugnaughts really do not like droids. Guys, please stop trying to zap our droids. You're being very rude. Oh my god, these guys. You're up, Chewie. Put old Goldie back together, will ya? I'm not sorry for what I did, but I'm sorry I had to do it. It would be hilarious if, like, just for this level, there was a mechanic where, like, Chewie actually was carrying 3PO the whole time. And anytime you wanted to access a joy panel, you had to like have Chewie turn around and defend 3PO while 3PO was doing his thing. That would be a fun little mechanic. Nice, we got ourselves an escape vehicle. Ooh, and stormtrooper helmets to boot. Very nice. Wow, Leia's like, oh heck no, I'm not wearing that. Look at how good my hair is today. I am not messing that up for anything. Let's cheese it! I can't believe these guys are helping themselves to the food at my cafes. This is ridiculous. I won't have it, I tell you. I am just killing everyone, even the civilians. I should be more, I really should be doing better at with that, as you know, as a hero. I'm committing war crimes here. I love that Landa just does a little bow. You're relieved of duty, troopers. Stop complaining, 3PO. Oh man, now even R2's giving me an earful over being blasted. Look guys, I'm sorry. Maybe it was a mistake to antagonize the troopers. Because they just seem to not be stopping at all now. There are a few beach troopers in there. Magnets, man, how do they work? Come on, guys, into the elevator. Are you guys coming or what? Well, I guess you're hopping it. Ha Come on, 3PO. I can't get over the little kick he does. He just like lifts his leg and does a little jab with it. And it kills the stormtroopers. You know, I'm glad I turned on blast deflect because these guys are extremely persistent, and if I hadn't, I would have probably lost a lot of money. He targets 3 shots. I get the feeling this is something I need to handle in free play. Alright, let's go. Let's get out of here. R2, would you be a lamb and fly across? Okay, I don't think we're getting across that way. Looks like I do need to get around here somehow. Oh wow, R2 doesn't need to worry about the gas at all. Nice. there's the ticket out of here. Let's go. My wallet's runneth over. It's always the beach trooper that's the last one. That's how you know you're at the end of the trooper rush. Let's go! Whoa. Where is Lando keeping that? Leia's just pumping the levers like crazy. She's like, oh, wait, we forgot something. Oh man, Luke's got a black eye and a hand, and she's like, oh man, that's messed up. Alright, there we are. Episode 5 of Star Wars. All wrapped up in a nice little bow. Back with the Rebel fleet. Aw man, poor Leia's heartbroken. Oh neat, new hand. Whoa! Just a bug, I'm sure. It'll work itself out. Lando, quit messing around with the controls. And why the heck are you wearing Han's clothes? Oh. Man, all that. And we're only not even halfway done. That's crazy. Whoa, 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 whoa. Stop, stop, Chewie, quit it. Stop. Look, I have Blast Deflect turned on. You literally can't hurt me. There is no reason for this hostility. Woohoo, do something! There's another bar fight happening. Don't you have like a bouncer or something? Come on, man. Ah. Had to buy it eventually. Wow! I have now purchased all the gold bricks. And I still have a healthy 260,000 left over. Well, with that, I'd say it's time to wrap things up. Whew! That was fun. Okay, so assuming you stuck around till the end, one, I commend you on your patience. You would make a fine Jedi with that kind of patience. And thank you, of course, for sticking around. Not just for this stream, but for all the ones prior, and hopefully for all the ones yet to come. I'm so pleased to have built such an amazing community around myself. Hold on, I should probably... There we go. This is a more appropriate screen for me yakking up. I'm really grateful to have built such a wonderful community, and I really can't wait to see where we go next from here. I'm even more excited to work on where we go next. But anyways, for now, thanks again for watching. Please join the New Persian Empire on Twitter, Discord, and YouTube. Twitter and Discord, where I put up my stream schedules, and Twitter especially is where I post a whole bunch of things, like what I cooked last night for, well, not dinner, but I ate it for today's dinner. Anyways, I made some nice dal chawal keema, which is a lovely little Parsi dish, and if you want to see what that looks like, go check out the Twitter. And Discord, of course, is where I plan on doing community streams once the Discord fills up a little more. So, why not join up? The community streams are definitely going to be a lot of fun. I'm going to be doing stuff there that I can't really do on Twitch for one reason or another. Copyright. So, yeah. Join up if it catches your fancy. And, of course, join YouTube. Subscribe on YouTube if you want to see VODs, as well as other fun stuff. Things like videos of me singing, which I did for Singing March. So anyways, yeah. Let's look for someone to raid. Let's see who's going. Da 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 da. Mackenzie, Boo Sheep. Morp, Vivi. Minato. Let's see. Let's raid Glitch Symphony. Haven't been to her stream in a while. Yeah, let's go visit Glitch. As for the raid message, that will be... what will it be? I think I'm just gonna say new affiliate raid. Hmm. There we go. Please make sure to copy that message, paste it in chat. Where we are going. Alright, let's get this raid started. Raid. And let's just... Glitch. Symphony. Yep. I believe that's it. What the? Oh. Oh boy. Let's try that again. There we go. Alright. Let's get this raid started. Once again, thank you all for watching. Thank you so much for getting me to affiliate. And I will see you guys on Friday for more Fallout. Later.